massive clog on our north-south axis from Rye Bridge to the Bergs Bridge, coming up from Rye through Top Rye and Macquarie Park. Previous state government had aligned a metro station underneath what used to be the Rye City Centre. Is there any proposal that you could potentially create some sort of metro system to unclog that area from Rye Bridge through to the Bergs Bridge? Because that seems to be blocked both ways.
The future transport document very much looks at how you build a metro network for Sydney. And I dare say, into the future, that type of investment would make sense, particularly given the fact that you have one of the highest concentrations of apartment dwellings in the country. And when these approvals were granted, no one actually thought, well, hang on a second, you go and put 10,000 people in these 5,000 apartments here, what's the consequence? Well, sorry to say, you're experiencing it. We're now having a retrofit, which is annoying. There's very much the concentration of apartments between the city and the airport are two areas which I just do not understand how anyone with any planning experience could have actually allowed that to happen. Anyway, it has, and we've now got to obviously deal with it. I think one of the great things about this government has been the fact that it has had the political fortitude, not Victor and I were extensively involved, but I was treasurer at the time, but we built significant headroom into our infrastructure spending by recycling capital. In my case, it was the Baltimore Wise transaction behind there, where we took it to the community and said, well, look, we want to get the private sector involved in the running of this state-owned asset. That allows us to bring forward the future cash flows to invest in new, productive infrastructure, which can, in essence, congest and bust Sydney. And that's what we've done. I mean, the metro is being paid for by the Colton Wise transaction. The world didn't end. We were able to legislate lower power prices in terms of the network charges and the network component of the electricity bill for consumers. So we're able to manage this, and I think we've got to continue that discipline in the future. The other side don't want to do this, they don't believe it. We do, because if you manage a state's balance sheet well, then you've got the ability to invest like this. And the only way that Metro is going to be able to continue into the future is if government continues to recycle capital, manage the finances well, keep the AAA credit rating, manage some degree of debt, and then at the same time make sure that we have well integrated planning in transport planning, which has now happened because of the Greater Sydney Commission working with the planners within transport to develop the Greater Sydney Commission plan sitting alongside the Future Transport 2056 document. So we've finally got that right. Hard to believe in 2018, but we'll find it then. So I'm very confident if we get into a virtual cycle of infrastructure investment, the project which you just alluded to is a very real proposition, particularly given the high concentration of people living in apartments in this part of Sydney.
And just quickly, what's this Sydney Gateway that will take?